Many of you might have had these on your bedroom ceilings as children.
But what is it that causes these stars to emit their eerie green glow after switching off the lights?
I'm Will.
And I'm Nerys.
And today we're investigating what makes things glow in the dark.
There are two main ways that things can glow, incandescence and luminescence.
Incandescence is seen when something gets hot. We can make this piece of metal hot by using a blowtorch.
Incandescence happens when the atoms of these materials vibrate at high temperatures, causing the metal to glow red hot.
Or we can use electricity to heat a wire to make a light bulb.
There's another way to make things glow using a small part of an atom, electrons.
Electrons move in a cloud around the nucleus of an atom. And when you give these electrons energy, they jump up an energy level to an excited state.
Electrons fall back into that ground state. They give off the energy as a flash of light. We call that luminescence.
To show you what we mean, we've got these flame guns.
By spraying metal solutions to the flames, we can make them glow.
The heat of the flame excites the electrons, and since different atoms have different numbers of electrons, each solution releases a unique colour of light.
Heat isn't the only way to give electrons energy. We could also use the energy from a chemical reaction. So here I have hydrogen peroxide and luminol. They don't look that special on their own, but if we dim the lights and mix them together,
or you can use electricity to give the electrons energy to make sweet electroluminescent lab coats.
Various creatures, from fungi to fireflies to deep sea fish, use reactions in their bodies to create light. We call this bioluminescence.
You can also use other forms of light to excite the electrons. This UV light here is going to cause these chemicals to glow.
This is known as fluorescence.
But what about our stars? In light, the electrons become excited. But in darkness, the electrons slowly release the energy, causing them to glow in the dark.
Here we've used the same material along a whole wall, so we can use light to make graffiti.
For more illuminating science, why not check out Ross walking across red-hot coals?
Coming soon, we'll be investigating how solar panels and plants use light to generate energy. So for more science every week, click subscribe. Thanks for watching.